亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，早安。
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
那今天的题目叫“快乐是新年”。
Today, my sermon title is Happy New Year.
但是大家都知道，已经新年已经过去几个星期了。
Of course, we know New Year's has gone a couple of weeks already.
那不是不应景，而是有新的意义在当中。
It's not that it's not, you know, according to time, but it's actually have a special meaning.
因为当我们在看神的话语的时候，我们看到有一些书卷叫智慧书。
Of course, when we are looking at the Bible, there's certain books are considered the books of wisdom.
这些可能是箴言，可能是传道书、雅歌，这几卷书都是说很有智慧的书卷。
It could be Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, some Songs of Solomon.
那你想一下。这些书卷对快乐这个字词有什么的理解呢？
What does this book have to say about the word happiness?
那如果你看箴言的时候，它有这样的说法。
If you look at Proverbs, it has this.
它说人在喜乐当中，喜笑当中，心也忧愁，快乐至极，昼生愁苦。
It says when men are in happiness, their heart might be in sorrow, they might be extremely happy.
你有没有听过我们人说乐极生悲吗？
Have you ever heard of a Chinese idiom saying if you're too happy, something bad will happen?
所以这一节的经文给我们一种的体验，就是究竟什么是快乐。
So here in the scripture, it really reminds us what is true happiness.
另外一节的经文，两三节的经文里面也有这样的说法。
Another book in the Bible also
shares this. 讲到去商家的家里面看的情况。
Going to a family's home, someone who a family member has passed away.
甚至可能去一些婚礼啊，参加的过程当中，心情是怎么样的
？Or going to someone's wedding, what a person's heart might feel.
在中文有两个字“强于”这两个字很有意思。
In the Chinese word, there's two words that are very interesting.
你想一下，你去那个婚礼的时候。坐在下边的人会怎么想呢？
When you are sitting in the banquet in the wedding, what would people feel?
尤其是遭遇婚姻不太开心的那些夫妇，看着他们很开心的时候，你等着吧。
Especially those who are not having a very bad marriage, when they see them happy and the wedding, they'll say, "Oh, you just wait."
那如果你去安息礼拜的话。
Or if you are attending a funeral service,
你在那里应该是愁苦的，但是你也很可以说是开心，看到现在我还没有轮到我。
Or if you attend a funeral service, you're sitting there, you should have a very sad emotion, but you have this kind of happiness that, oh, I'm not there yet.
所以这个强于很有意思，在这两节三节的经文当中。
So here in the Bible, it says it's better this word is very interesting.
究竟什么的情况当中才是快乐？有一个很不同的那个定义。
When should you be happy? And different circumstances have different meanings.
所以我看到这些智慧的书卷当中，给我们要去寻求那个什么的是智慧。
Here in the book of wisdom, we want to seek what true wisdom, true happiness is.
面对我们的人生。
In order to face the different stages in life.
那你想一下，讲到快乐新年的时候，什么是新年，什么是快乐呢？
So when we say Happy New Year, what is happy? What is New Year?
那当然，我有我的那个新年的意义，等一等会跟大家分享。
Of course, I have a meaning for New Year, which I will share with everyone a little bit later.
当然，怎么作为快乐也有不同的定义在当中。
Of course, the word happy also have different meaning.
所以，当我们看这个两节的经文的时候，我们就发觉有很多不同的那个想法。
So when we look at Ecclesiastes that we were just read, it has different meanings for us as well.
这里给我们看到年轻的时候，你要想什么，你要看什么，随便去啦。
It says when you're young, you let your heart give you joy and look at whatever you want to look.
但是传道者在这里告诉我们，有一个很不同的角度，我们需要去理解看的。
But I also want to tell us that there's a different perspective that we need to look at.
好，我们一起来做个祷告哈，开始。
Let us pray together.
主耶稣，我们看到你智慧的书卷当中给我们学习智慧。
Lord Jesus, we know that in the book of wisdom, you want us to learn your wisdom.
当今天传道姐像讲到一些话语的时候，我们去思想一下我们的人生。
Lord, may we ponder upon the words from Ecclesiastes.
看到这个新年有什么意义？
To understand what meaning it is for New Year's.
也看到什么是真正的快乐。
And also understand what is true happiness.
当我们来到你的面前领受你的话语的时候，求主你的灵与我们同在。
Lord, when we come to learn your words, may your Holy Spirit to move freely amongst us.
感动我们，让我们明白你的话语。
Touch us, make us understand what a meaning is for your words.
我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名求。
We pray this all in the name of Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
那我们讲到快乐新年的时候，是不是什么事情就很顺心，就是快乐呢？
When we talk about Happy New Year, does that mean everything is going according to our own will? That's considered Happy New Year.
那或者是我们得到很多的财富，什么都得到就是快乐呢？
Or happiness is considered us having a lot of wealth, obtaining things that we have been wanting.
当我们讲到快乐的过程当中，我们其实是预知有一种的不快乐的事情。
Actually, when we're talking about happiness, we actually are portraying that there is something that's unhappy.
所以当我们从不快乐的根源去看事情的时候，我们就知道快乐跟不快乐是怎么的一回事。
When we look at the foundation of unhappiness, we'll be able to distinguish the difference between happy and unhappiness.
比方我们家庭不快乐的时候，也是我们一种的不快乐的根源之一。
When our family is unhappy, that's also actually a foundation of unhappiness.
很多我们不快乐的原因，就是我们原生家庭，尤其是我们父母遗传给我们的一些不快乐的根源。
One thing for us to be unhappy is because our parents has ingrained something that's unhappy as the foundation for us.
你知道上一代的我们的父母是当结婚的那一天才知道对方的样子的。
Actually, our parents' generation, when the day of the wedding is the day that they know each other's looks, what they look like.
我们今天没办法想象这个怎么样是一个婚姻可以延续下去的。
It's very very interesting and for us to think about how this kind of marriage can last.
所以我们看到父母当中有很多不和谐的地方，也有家暴的事情发生。
We see that our parents there's a lot of disagreements and even abuse, physical abuse.
这些不开心的事情也让我们在旁边的儿女看着的时候也很多的不开心的事情。
And when we see these as children, these put in bad memories for us.
如果爸爸或者妈妈跟我们说，如果不当时不是你的话，我就可以很快乐了。
If your parents would once say to the other, if it wasn't for you, I would be a lot happier today.
你想一下，这种的说法对我们有多大的伤害
？How much hurt this puts onto us?
尤其是爸爸妈妈爱儿女的时候，又有偏心的情况出现。
Or even when parents having multiple children, they have favorites amongst the kids.
尤其是我们中国家庭重男轻女的时候，女性就很多的苦难了。
Especially the Chinese culture where boys are a lot more favored than girls, girls will have this resentment in their hearts.
所有家里的东西都是女性来做的。
Because everything has to be done by the girls.
如果是弟弟要上学的，姐姐要去打工来赚钱呢？
If the younger brother or the older brother wants to go to school, the sister, the girls in the house have to make money to send the boys to school.
我一直觉得我们中国的女性很苦的。
I always think that the girls in the Chinese culture, it's very, very sad. It's very bad for them.
究竟男生怎么样去有一种性感的表现呢？
How can a man have a sexy appearance for them?
你觉得女性才有 sexy， 但是男生都有的。
You might only think that the girls can be sexy, but actually boys, men can be sexy as well.
我那个在统计来说，有一个说法就是男性之所以是很性感，因为他很幽默。
Statistics shows that men is sexy because they are very humorous.
啊，你知道女性的性感就是样子啦、身材啦，但是男生是幽默。
Women, in order to consider them as sexy, they actually have to have physical appearance, but men, they just have to have humor and they're considered sexy.
你知道什么原因吗？
Do you know the reason why?
因为女生很苦嘛，看到男生很幽默，很开心，就给他开心咯。
Because if girls are there often doing all these things, they're very sorrow, and if a guy is very humorous, you know, that will make them very sexy.
所以男生要更性感，幽默一点。
So men, in order for you to be more sexy, you have to be more humorous.
那你就可以理解到是那个在家庭不开心的时候很多的令到我们难受的。
Now you can see that in your family, if you have a lot of unhappiness, that will actually engrave into your heart.
父母不开心，儿女不开心，自己弟兄姊妹也有不和的事情发生。
When your family, when your kids and the parents are unhappy, when you come into church setting, you will have a disagreement and unhappiness between brothers and sisters.
你想一下，今天我们多长时间没跟我们的兄弟姊妹有交往了？
Now we, brothers and sisters, now if you think about how often do we talk to our siblings?
这种就是不快乐的根源的其中一种家庭的事情。
And that's because of the foundation of our family that causes unhappiness, and therefore you don't really talk to your siblings.
还有其他的不开心的事情在我们人生当中的。
There are also other unhappy things that occurs in our life.
我称为真情假意。
I consider very fake.
因为我们人生当中有人际的关系嘛。
In our life, we have social circles.
那年轻的时候，那恋爱的事情就是其中一种了。
When you're young, and when you're young, of course, getting into relationship is one of the things.
我常常讲到都会提到我从香港来到美国读书的过程的那种苦。
When I share about certain sermons, I often share about when I came from Hong Kong to U.S. to study, the sorrow, the difficult times that I experienced.
那当时我的女朋友跟我说：“你去四年啊，等不了。”
My girlfriend at the time said to me, "You're going to be gone for 4 years. I don't think I can wait for you."
我说我每年回来呀。
I said to her, "Oh, I'll come back every year."
后来我才发现她有另外一个男生了。
Then I realized actually it's because she has someone else.
四年都等不了吗？
She couldn't wait for 4 years.
哇，那个时候来到美国之后，每天看着天花板。
Every night when I was laying in bed, I'm looking at the ceiling.
你知道天花板都是白的。
You know that the ceiling is white.
这个教会的天花板比较漂亮。
The ceiling here is quite pretty.
那看到一个月就是这样。
I've looked at the ceiling for a month. It's the same.
哎呀，还好以前有这个苦。
Actually, I'm glad that I experienced difficult times.
现在才知道我有现在的老婆多好。
Then I realized how fortunate I am to have my wife now.
你知道我们人生当中也有很多朋友啊，有人际关系，但是很多时候我们发觉我们跟人家的关系断绝的时候很难受。
We have our friends, social circles, but when we have disagreement and we depart from each other, that pain, it's unbearable.
我现在牧会已经30多年了，其中有一些弟兄姊妹是我的会友，但是现在跟我没有关系的时候，我心里很难受的。
I've been nurturing a church for over 30 years, and there's brothers and sisters that I used to serve together, and now we don't even consider each other friends, and it's really very difficult and sad for me.
不单只是这样，有很多的事情，事与愿违也是我们不快乐的根源。
And aside from that, there's things that don't meet our expectation that causes us to be unhappy.
你想一下，很多的事情发生的时候，我们想都没想过的。
For example, when things happen that we didn't even think about in the past, that causes us unhappy.
就在我们当中也有这样的事情发生。
Even amongst us, there's things that happen that surprises us.
刚才也令到我们的周牧师很感动的，差一点流泪了。
Something that touched our pastor so much that he almost shed tears.
不想出现的事情偏偏就出现了。
Things that we don't want to see that actually happened.
你年纪越长，你发生这些事情就越多。
The older you get, the more things that pop out of nowhere happens.
所以你想一下， 不快乐的根源是多么的厉害，影响我们人生。
You can see that the foundation of unhappiness can occur all over the place and can surprise us all the time.
所以我们今天的信息的第二点就是需要有不快乐的更新。
So therefore today, the second part of the scripture is a renewal of unhappiness.
所谓的不快乐的更新的意思就是要将我们的态度要改变。
What does it mean to have a renewal of unhappiness? It really means to change our attitude towards things.
原来我们对不同的事物的那个态度不同呢，影响我们对这个人生快乐与不快乐有绝大的很大的影响的。
The attitude that we have towards the unhappy things in our life that occurs it really changes the way that we view things.
比方来说，我们对那个不快乐已经有一种预示它的存在的时候，那种态度就不同了。
When we have something in our mind knowing the unhappy things is happening, that would change us.
那当我们已经预知它会存在，我们就觉得，哎，现在有这个事情发生，哎，我也很知道，早就知道了。
For example, if we have this mindset that, oh, I already kind of see this happening, I already have an understanding that this will occur, then your mindset will be, your viewpoint will be different.
甚至我们觉得，哎呀，我们能够预知这个存在，我很算很聪明呢。
Or even think to yourself, oh, I can predict that this was going to happen. I'm actually pretty smart.
你想一想，我们刚才读的两节的经文，传道书那个两节的经文之前一节。怎么说呢？
If we look at the scripture Ecclesiastes chapter 9 that we read, what did the verse before say?
就是第八节，我们一起来读一下，好不好？
That is verse 8. Let's read it all together.
人活多年，就当快乐的多年，然而也当想到黑暗的日子，因为这日子必多，所要来的都是虚空。
Basically, it says, man, we live for many years, we can be happy for many years, but then we have to think about the dark days because those days are many. All things in those times are meaningless.
你想一下，黑暗的日子很多啊。
We have to think about there are a lot of dark days.
就是说，我们人生当中不如意的事情十常八九的意思。
That means in our lifetime, there are a lot of unfortunate things that happen that is out of our imagination.
但是如果我们在面对这种的情况的时候，处之泰然的话。
But when we are in those kind of circumstances, we're already down.
因为你预知它的存在。
And you're able to predict that these things are going to happen.
那现在过了很久才出现的时候，你说，哎呀，这么久才来呀。
And then a long while later, you realize, oh, it's finally happening.
好像自己占了一样。
Maybe you think, oh, I'm predicting all these happening.
所以你看，面对所有的这种难处，就是我们另外一种的态度。
When we face these difficult times, the dark days, the attitude that we have towards it, it's what makes us successful.
因为我们预知它的存在，现在呢，我们要面对它的存在。
Because we have predicted it happening, now we have to face it.
那当我们知道我们的不快乐的根源，就是家庭的来源，我们就有这种面对家庭的那个不开心难处的这种态度。
When we know that the foundation of our unhappiness came from our family, so then we know how to deal with this unhappiness when we face the difficult time.
所以蛮有智慧的那个所罗门就跟我们这样说了。
King Solomon, who is full of wisdom, he said this to us.
你要使父母欢喜，使生你的快乐。
You have to make those who gave birth to you joy, give them happiness.
你想一下，刚才我们说嘛，父母或者是家庭都让我们有一种不快乐的原因。
We know from earlier that one of the reasons we're unhappy is because of our parents.
但是所罗门告诉我们，你要令到你的家庭开心，你的父母开心，生你的快乐。
But Solomon says you have to make a joy to the one who have given birth to you, give joy to your parents.
所以今天我们要理解，我们人生的成功的最大的成就，就是令到你的家庭和乐。
We know today that the most successful thing that we can do is to make joy, give joy to your parents.
你想一下，当你的太太不开心的时候，你令到她很开心的时候，你够性感的时候，那就好了。
when you're, for example, when your wife is unhappy and you want to do something for her, you be humorous, you become sexy in front of her, therefore she'll be happy.
你想一下，太太开心，你一定开心。
And happy wife, happy life, you'll be happy.
你就可以想到这个是多么重要的事情。
You can see how important that concept is.
有人说嘛，你要朝着太阳，不要背着太阳。
We often say you have to face the sun, not behind, not be back towards it.
朝着太阳当然很刺眼的那个光，但是你的影子，你的阴暗面在后面。
When you're facing the sun, even though it's so bright, it might be blind to your eyes, but you're headed towards the sun, your shadow, the dark parts are behind you.
所以我们要面对它。
So therefore, we have to face the sun.
而且呢，我们还要接受它的存在。
And we also have to accept its presence.
当我们有这种的态度，就是接受这种苦难在我们生命当中的时候，我们叫什么？与那个苦难共舞。
When you have the difficulty in front of you, you want to face it. You acknowledge existence and you want to walk with it.
有一本书呢，有一本书这告诉我们这种的想法。
A book tells us this kind of mindset.
就是一个诗人所说的一句话。
And that is a phrase spoken by a psalmist.
我受苦是与我有益的。
I've gone through suffering, it is for my own good.
就可以理解到神的律例典章。
In order for me to understand your laws and commandments.
所以这本书就叫与苦难共舞。
And the name of the book, paraphrasing, is Dance with Suffering. Dance along with suffering.
这本书是一个香港的一个牧师所写的。
It's a book written by a pastor in Hong Kong.
他告诉我们怎么样呢？在过去十四年当中，他四次那个有癌症。
The pastor shared with us in the book that he had experienced four cancers in the 14 years.
而且呢，有四次的肺炎。
Four pneumonias.
所以你看到这个牧师怎么说呢
？What does this pastor say?
他说：“我向你见证。”
I want to be a testimony to you.
当然，见证是很长的一个事情。
Of course, testimony is very long.
而且他说，即保证 ，guarantee.
It's a guarantee.
那你想一下，好像保险公司一样，保障你这个，保障你那个意思吗
？It's just like an insurance company promising this, promising that.
保障什么呢？保证什么呢
What are we guaranteeing about?
神的恩典是够用的，受苦。与我有益。
That is God's that God's faithfulness is always there. It's always sufficient. The guarantee is always there.
当这个牧师经历了这么多的难处的时候，他告诉这个读者：“我保证你的。”
After the pastor has gone through all these sufferings, he wants to guarantee to the readers, "This is what I want to show you."
保证你知道与苦难来共舞是实在是美好的。
I want to guarantee you that to dance along with suffering, it's actually for your own good.
所以当我们看到这一点的时候，我们就发觉原来真的有很大的一个学习的地方。
When we understand this, we'll know that there's a lot of things for us to learn.
回到我们今天的那个议题，就是快乐新年的时候，我们知道不开心的那个不快乐的根源了。
Now reflecting back to the title of the sermon, Happy New Year, we know the foundation of unhappiness.
我们也知道我们要更新自己了。
We also know that we have to renew ourselves, from the unhappiness.
不单只是预知它的存在。
Not only predicting its existence.
而且能够面对它。
We are able to face the difficulty.
甚至与苦难来共舞的，来去面对这种苦难。
And also learning to accept.Its existence and dance along with it.
今天我们信息的第三点就是什么呢？要不快乐的终结。
What is the third point of today's title? It's terminate unhappiness.
终结这个字可以是名词，就是停止啦这个意思。
The word terminate meaning stop, putting a pause.
但是也可以是一个动词。
It could also be a verb.
那你听过那个 Terminator 吗？
Have you heard of the movie Terminator?
他说 I'm back.
He says I'm back.
那就是我来 terminate, 就是终结一些事情。
Meaning he's we are coming to terminate to end something.
当我们面对不快乐的时候，我们来做一个终结这个不快乐的人。
So therefore, when we are facing something and that's unhappy, let us be a terminator to go ahead and end that unhappiness.
你想一下神的话语怎么告诉我们呢？
Let us think about what God has told us in His
words. 刚才我们看到的传道书的两节的经文。
From the scripture that we had read earlier.
当你少年的时候，你想到什么都就做吧，你看到什么都乐一下吧。
It says, "Be happy, young man. While you are young, let your heart give you joy. Do whatever you please, and whatever is pleasing to your eyes."
然后他说，却要知道。
He says, "But know that."
在这一切事情之后。神必审问你。
For all these things, God will bring you to judgment.
那对我们基督徒来说，有一个很重要的事情，我们有没有想到有上帝，有神呢？
For us Christians, we understand that there is God, there's a Lord.
如果说上帝必审问我，或者是神必审问我的时候，这个神，这个主要的人物，我们对他有多少的知道？
So we know that God will bring us judgment, then how much understanding do we have? How much do we know the Lord who will bring judgment?
究竟他在我们人生当中有多重要的位置?
And what kind of importance does he have in our life?
我们对这个智慧节谈到这个上帝、这个神、这个智的时候、这个人物的时候，我们对他有什么的态度？
What kind of attitudes do we have towards what they say about God?
你想到他有审判的权利。
He has the power to fulfill judgment.
你要知道啊。
You have to understand that.
在你一切所做的事情，他会审问你的。
In every single thing that you do, he will bring judgment.
这个对我来说有一个很大的一个感受。
To me, it stirs my heart a little bit.
因为我自己有一个这样的那个经历。
Because I have had this experience.
就是去年底的时候，我看了一本书，这本书是1941年一个牧师的遗著。
And that is at the end of last year, I read a book that was written by a pastor.
他离开世界之前写的这本书。
Right before he left the world, he wrote this book.
其中一章讲到那个圣洁。
One word he mentioned was holiness.
他这一章里面讲到圣洁，就是告诉我们作为一个基督徒，我们要圣洁咯。
It's basically him telling us, being Christians, we have to be holy.
他引用了很多的经文。
He utilized a lot of Bible verses.
一一的去解释。
And he explained each verse that he mentioned.
其中一节的经文对我来说是非常熟的，就我对他非常突然之间有很大的感受。
One of the passages that he mentioned, I know this verse very well, but after reading the book, I have very deep thought towards it.
希伯来书十二章里那里说，非圣洁人就不能看到主了。
That is in Hebrews chapter 12, it says, unless you're holy, you will not be able to see the Lord.
非圣洁人就不能看到主的这句话，好像一拳打到我胸口。
Unless you're holy, you will not see the Lord. This phrase, this word, really touched my heart. It's like a punch towards my heart.
因为我在想的时候，我在1981年来到美国读书啦。
Because to me,
80年在美国读书。
Because to me, I'm thinking to myself, in 1980, I came to U.S. to have studies.
81年的是我的生命改变。
81, my life changed.
85年我就去那读神学了。
And 1985, I went to seminary school.
89年我就安立做牧师了。
And 1989, I became a pastor.
我牧会有8年之久。
And I've been shepherding the church for 8 years.
后来跟我爸爸一起来去创立那个纽约神学教育中心。
And later on, with my father, we started New York Seminary School.
我们在2001年就推出这个网络那个教学。
And in 2000, we started Chinese Seminary School online seminary school.
哇，想一下，现在已经32年了。
Now I think about it. Oh, it's actually been 32 years.
但是讲到圣洁，我发觉我自己够不上。
But when I talk about the word holy.I'm actually far away from it.
作为一个基督徒，作为一个牧师，还够不上圣洁，没办法见主面哦。
As a pastor, as a Christian, if I'm not holy, I can't see the Lord.
你想一下，每次我在在那个去那个纽约那个 Shea Stadium 的时候，有两个很大的树木在哪里？
When I head to a stadium in your city, there's two big trees, huge trees in front.
第一个就是现在563个 million.
$563 million.
另外一个就412 million.
The other one is $412 million.
你知道是什么呢
？What is that?
就是那个 mega 那个中奖的那个数字嘛。
That's the Mega Million, the lottery ticket.
快快来买哦！
Gotta start buying it.
每次经过的时候，我就说，哇，我是一次拿它，还是20年拿
了 ？Every time I pass it, I'm thinking, should I just take it all at one shot, or should I split it up in 20 years?
还是一次性的拿了。
I think it's better just take it all at one shot.
钱在我自己再带你多好。
I put it in my pocket. How beautiful that is.
那现在563就是哇，2亿多，那我要分多少个基金来去支持不同的机构呢？
I'm thinking to myself, $500 plus a million dollars.
其中一个给主爱之家。
I can share with House of Christ Love and many other ministries.
我都看到这个，每次看到都是在想。
Every time I look at it, I'm thinking to myself.
我说神啊，如果你有一天晚上给我6个数字，我一定明天就去买。
I say to the Lord, Lord, if you give me 6 numbers, I will go buy it tomorrow.
不要说这个了，其实如果用圣经的要求面对我一个作为男生，那有没有犯奸淫的话，我觉得我过去多年犯了不知多少次。
If I look at the Bible as a man, as a male, I'm looking at about sexual desires. How many times I have offended the Lord?
就是
too many to count.
等于就是奸淫呢。
Adultery. How many
所以你想一下，作为一个基督徒，作为一个牧师，一样有这样的经历。
As a Christian, as a pastor, I have all these experiences.
我刚才已经说了，我也有很多的人际关系的断绝的关系的出现。
I have shared with you earlier. I have many broken relationships, throughout the years.
无论是那个我的会友、朋友，甚至我的兄弟。
Friends, church members, even my brothers.
所以我就在说吧，如果用圣洁来去衡量邱放河的时候，他一定看不了，见不了主的面。
If I use holiness to weigh, Pastor Chu, I would not be able to see the Lord.
如果是这样的话，究竟我应该怎么样去面对呢
？So then, I think to myself, how do I face that?
我就开始想到刚才所讲的话，却要知道。在这一切的事，神必审问你的。
And I think about back to the verse we just read, but know that for all these things, God will bring you to judgment.
所以从去年底到现在，我一直在想的议题，我就想要跟弟兄姊妹来分享一下。
And so therefore, ever since the end of the last year, I started thinking about this and want to share with brothers and sisters.
我的新年不是农历新年，也不是一月一号的新年。
I am not saying my New Year it does not start on January 1st or Lunar New Year.
我的新年就是在我的人生当中哪个时候切开新的一页的时候，那个就是我的新年。
My New Year is when I have flipped over to a new chapter of my life. That is considered my New Year.
所以当这个新年对我的意义是完全是不同的。
The word New Year has a different meaning for me.
在那个时候我就开始想到一个所谓的 slogan 或者是自己的指导的那个一句话。
I started to have the slogan for myself.
就是认真信仰享受学习。
That is to fully devote in the words and then enjoy learning.
如果我要切开这个新的一页呢？
What about when I flip over to a new chapter?
我作为一个牧师、传道人、基督徒，我不能马马虎虎的去过我的一生了。
Me as a pastor, as a Christian, I cannot just dilly dally with my life.
我需要认真我的信仰。
I need to develop in my faith.
这个是什么意思呢？
What do I mean by that?
你想一下，我们信了多少年？
Think to yourself, how many years have you believed?
现在是教会的领袖。
You are a leader in a church.
长老、执事，甚至牧师、传道人。
Elder, deacon, preacher, pastor.
我们有没有真正的认真我们的信仰？
How devoted are we towards our faith?
我们对任何的事情都很相信，就是这本书不相信。
We believe in everything that's happening around us, but we do not believe the Bible.
但是如果我们真正的认真我们自己的信仰的时候，
But when we truly devote in our faith,
我们肯定不是这样的。
We will not be like this.
大家都有一个学位。
You all have your degrees.
你的学位可能是几年拿下来的，或者是花了很长时间拿下来的。
Maybe you got your degree in 4 years, maybe 8 years, maybe even longer.
但是我作为一个信徒，我没有这个认真度。
But me as a disciple, a follower of Christ, I'm not
没有这种认真去来去为了一个学位来去认真的程度来去对我们的神。
We did not have the same focus towards our degree like we have with the Lord's Word.
我为什么说享受那个学习呢？
Why did I say to enjoy studying?
你想一下，当你在读神的话语的时候，有亮光出现的时候。
What I mean is when you are looking at God's Word, the Bible, there are lights coming towards you.
你享受吗？
Wouldn't you be joyous?
应该是享受的。
You should be enjoying.
哇，原来我的神这么奇妙的。
Ah, my God, he's so marvelous.
他可以让我在苦难当中跟他跳舞的。
I can dance along with him in my difficult
times. 哇，这样可以引导我这样走，就走一个更顺心的那个路的时候。
I can be able to go on a path that is even better, even more welcoming with him.
或者神的话语光照我，让我看到更大的一个境界的时候，眼界打开的时候。
Or God's word shine the light on me, able to see something that's even more vast for me.
你享受吗？
Would you enjoy it?
请问享受的时间多吗？
Now, do you enjoy this for how long? For a standard period of time?
你享受玩游戏机的时候，你天天去玩。
When you're playing video games, you play day in and day out.
你享受去吃东西的时候，你常常去那个餐馆去吃。
When you want to enjoy your food, you go to different restaurants multiple times.
讲到享受学习的时候，你跟神的之间的关系有进一步的时候，你会不会继续的去享受，来去继续的学习？
When I talk about enjoying God's word, would you take even more time to learn, to enjoy, and then that would trigger you to even want to read even more?
所以讲到认真的信仰的时候，享受那个学习的时候，就是这个角度去看。
When I say diligently being devoted into learning, that's the angle that I'm talking about.
当你去这样去认真我们的信仰的时候，你的行为都会改变。
Your actions and your way of living will be completely changed when you have this kind of understanding.
你的心态也会改变。
Your attitude will also change.
我刚才说，我跟我的兄弟，就是我的二哥之间有些难处出现几年前。
When I mentioned to you, I have some discrepancies with my brother. It's my second older brother that I have some.
他有他的见解，我有我的坚持。
He has his understanding. I have my thoughts.
互不相让。
We would not let each other's thoughts come cross.
从那个时候，我们就没交往了。
And from then on, we stopped having communications.
但是去年我经历了这种的性结不能非性结不能见主面的时候。
But towards the end of last year, when I noticed, unless you're holy, you will not see the Lord.
我一直在思想这个事情。
I've been pondering upon this.
今年二月六号，我不知道我跟我的大姐在谈事情的时候，突然之间谈起我的二哥的事情。
February 6th, I was talking to my oldest sister. We were chit-chatting, and then all of a sudden, my second oldest brother's name came upon the conversation.
他跟我说出我的二哥的想法的时候。
When my older sister shared about my second oldest brother's thoughts to me,
我突然之间咚看到一个不同的境界，或者是应该说能够看到我的二哥的角度去看事情。
All of a sudden, a light bulb lit up in my head. I was able to understand where he was coming from, from his point of view.
所以我现在要准备要向我的二哥来去改变我们之间的联系的这个地方。
So now I'm attempting, I'm trying to amend the relationship I have with him.
你知道那个是不容易的。
You understand that it's not an easy thing.
因为他曾经骂我，你这个牧师做到这样的。
Because at one point he even said, "You're a pastor. How can you be a pastor like this?"
我说你做这个二哥做到这样也不配做二哥。
And I responded to him, "You're an older brother, second older brother, and you are doing like that."
但是如果学习到一件事情的时候，我就要认真我的信仰。
Once I learn something, therefore I want to be devoted in my faith.
弟兄姊妹们，今天跟你们分享这些事情的时候，
Dear brothers and sisters, when I share these things with you today,
我只能够说神很恩待你们。
All I can say is God is blessing you guys all.
让你们也听到这种的信息。
That you are able to hear these messages.
究竟今天是你的新年切开新的一页，还是仍然在新年之前？
That is whether you are at the new year, meaning flipping over a chapter, or you're still in the old year.
如果你的心打开的话，好像这个图画的一样，你打开你的心的时候，你就有一种构建你自己的新年的一个意义。
But when you're willing to open your heart, just like the photo, that means you're able to flip over.
当你愿意打开心来去构建你自己的新年的时候，我觉得快乐就会随着过来。
When you're willing to open your heart, we're ready to build your own new year, flipping over a chapter, your happiness will come soon.
我在想呢，当我跟我的二哥讲了之后，我们两个拥抱的时候，多好！
I think to myself, if I'm able to talk to my second oldest brother, if we're able to hug, how beautiful that would be.
求主也帮助我们每一个。May
God help us all.
我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
亲爱的主耶稣，我们谢谢你。
Lord Jesus, we thank you.
当你让我们看到你的奇妙的时候，
When you help us see how marvelous you are.
你打开我们的心，
You open our hearts.
来去跟随你，
To follow you.
你要我们很认真的我们自己的信仰，
You want us to be fully devoted in our faith.
因为我们可以在其中可以享受学习到的东西，
Because we can enjoy the things that we are learning.
我希望每一个弟兄姊妹都有一个新年，
I hope that all brothers and sisters can have a new chapter, a new year.
而且是一个快乐的新年。
That is also a happy new year.
因为我们知道你让我们跟随你。
Because Lord, we know that you want us to follow you.
你也告诉我们有一天会审问我们一切所做的。
Yeah, you will also tell us that one day all things will be in judgment.
就让我们今天来到你的面前，诚心的跟随你。
Lord, help us to follow you devotedly.
认真我们对你的信仰。
So that we can be fully devoted in following your words.
而且一直着享受跟你的同在。
And that we continuously enjoy the presence with you.
直到哪一天？
Until the end time.
我们这样祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名求。
We pray this all in the name of Lord Jesus.
Amen.